Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will see how to construct and present the research question in your research paper. We will also look at other components that make up the final paragraph of the introduction section of your paper. The research questions are normally the aims and objectives of your work. The research question pinpoints exactly what it is you want to find out in your work. You can have a single research question or multiple research questions in your paper depending on the complexity of your research. Generally, it is a good idea to keep the number of research questions to less than 4. The research question is normally one of the major components of the final paragraph of the introduction section. The last paragraph of your introduction section will typically contain the following parts. You can start this section by clearly defining the research question, which is the aims and objectives of your work. If your work is driven by a hypothesis, then you have to define your hypothesis here. Then, you need to tell your readers how you are planning to achieve your aims and objectives. You can do this by providing a brief summary of your methodology. Then, you can talk about the originality of your work. You can explain how your work differs from previous work. You can also provide a brief summary of your results here. You can add 1 or 2 lines summarizing the overall findings of your work. You can also talk about the implications of your research here. This will give the readers an instant idea of the possible benefits of your work. You can finish up this section with a brief description of the structure of your paper. You can tell your readers in what order various sections of your paper will be presented. Now let's look at some examples. Here is an example from a health sciences research paper. The passage starts with the research gap. The authors are saying that there is a need for a better understanding of the relationship between social media and mental health. Then, the authors explain the aims of their research and elaborate on what methodology they will be using to achieve their aims. The authors say that they will be using online surveys and face-to-face interviews to collect data to answer their research question. The passage flows very well, and the author nicely lays out the research gap, the study aims, and plan of action. Here is a slightly different variant of the previous example. Here, the authors have formulated the research question in the form of a hypothesis. Same as before, the authors are establishing the research gap in the first statement. In the next couple of statements, they are defining a specific hypothesis that they will be testing in the paper. In this case, they are testing the link between social media and mental health. And in the final statement, they are explaining the research methodology they will be employing to either prove or disprove the hypothesis. This is a pretty good example to follow if your research work is hypothesis-driven. Here is an example from a computer sciences research paper. The authors establish the research gap by saying that there aren't many papers on the topic of stock price prediction. Then, they explain what they are proposing. They are proposing a new method called the hybrid prediction model. Then, they are providing a brief breakdown of their method by explaining how their method functions. They are saying that in their approach, they are combining multiple methods in a structured way to improve the overall prediction accuracy of stock prices. Finally, they finish off the section by providing the outline of the paper. Please note, providing the paper outline is optional. It depends on your personal preference and journal requirements. This passage is a typical format you will see in engineering research papers that propose a new method to solve a particular problem. Here is an example from a psychology research paper. In the first line, the authors clearly state the research question and the methodology they will be using to address it. The authors aim to test the impact of background music on the listener's ability to remember words. They will be addressing this by performing a series of experiments in which observers will be shown words on the computer screen while playing different types of background music. Then they are finishing off the section with a very brief summary of the results. This is a good idea because it will provide readers with a rough idea of what to expect from the rest of the paper. I hope you found the presentation useful. See you in the next video. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you are interested in watching the extended version of this training course and learn more about research and academic writing, please visit Our Learning Academy. You can find the link in the description below. If you still haven't installed RefnWrite software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now.